Right, well, the next step in the rebuild process is to gap all the rings. You can see we've got our rings. Let's see if we can get a good shot. Yeah, you can see there's two rings in that cylinder, two rings in every cylinder now. And same thing here. There's only one here. I've saved one to do. I have one last ring to gap. What you need is a ring gap and grinder. You need it. I mean, I don't know. This is definitely not the way to file rings. If you're building an engine that you don't need to last very long, I guess maybe you can get by with that. But you want the gap ends nice and square. This tool will do it for you. And what you got to be careful of is that you don't want to take too much off the end of the rings. And the first time I used it, I took a little bit too much. So you gotta go nice and easy. And you'll see when I do the last ring what needs to be done. And then I come in, and on my sheet I write down all the gap clearances. Just take a feeler gauge and measure the gap on your rings. A lot of stuff you need to check with the manufacturer of your specific piston and rings, and see what they recommend. This is a sheet I got from Sealed Power. These are Sealed Power rings, Sealed Power pistons, and they recommend 4/1000ths of an inch per bore diameter on the top ring, and 5/1000ths of an inch per bore diameter on the second ring. Again, you need to check with the manufacturer, but that's what's specified for my rings. That's what I'm shooting for, this range of gap. And you simply put the ring in there, you square it up with a piston, and then you measure the gap. If it's not enough, you go take a little more, you come back and try it again. Before I even started, I coated the cylinders with a little bit of oil, just so it's not bare metal to metal contact. It's not going to do much. You're not with your hand. You're not going to do that much damage, but I do it anyway. So let's do that last ring. I'll put it up on the tripod, and we'll go from there. So I haven't even cut this ring yet, but I know there's zero gap rings. So just put it in like this with the end gap to the top and slide it down. And then you can just simply turn them like this. Then go grab a piston. Doesn't matter which one, because this is not the final fit. And just push it down a little bit, just so you're settling the rings in. And now your rings are square in the bore, and you can take a measurement. I'm not even going to try measuring this because it's zero gap right now. I can see that visually. So bring the ring over to the grinder. You have to also identify which way your rings go. And with these Seal Power rings, these first of all are the second rings, and I identified them through a bevel. But they also state that if you have a marked side with either a dot or some type of marking, those go to the top. So this is the top of the ring, and that's how you want to line it up, because you want to cut from the front towards the back. There's actually an edge, probably not on these are cast iron, but the top rings have an edge on them, which is manufactured onto the ductile iron rings. And if you file away from the center, you're actually ripping that out. So you file towards the center, and that way you get a nice smooth finish. So you lay it down on the grinder. These pins help you align the top of it, and you push in on this side. You only want to grind one side of the ring. The reason for that is that this is a manufactured edge, and if you close them up like this, you can see that they fit nice and square. If you were to take off from both sides, you wouldn't be sure that you have a square edge. So I just take off from one side away from that mark, so I can always have that and work my way this way. So working from the front towards the back, so that means you're actually grinding this wheel backwards here. So as you're grinding, you're pushing the ring towards the grinder itself. And I've done 7 of them, so I know that it takes at least a few turns to get the first measurements to even start. So I took, I don't know what it was there, maybe 5, something like that. I'm going to start there, and I just try and wipe off all that metal that I just shaved. And then I go over to the cylinder, like I just showed you, put it in a cylinder, take a piston, square it up, and measure it. I'm gonna go do that right now. I need to take some more. So bring it back, make sure I'm facing the correct way, facing up. If you turn it upside down, I don't know that it would do much harm, actually, as long as you grind in the correct direction, which is back towards the center. And that grinding, filing directions also comes from Speed Pro on the same sheet, Seal Power on the same sheet. It says right here, file outside face toward inside diameter. And file one end of the ring only. So that's the manufacturer specification or recommendations. That's the way you want to do it. Okay. So that's a few turns there. I'll go put this back and see where we're at. We are tight, but close, very close. So I'm just going to take maybe another half a turn right now, as long as I make sure I get a good grind for half a turn. Maybe that's all. Not even a half a turn. We are close. Time, I think I'll be right on now with the
measurement.
And you just want to kind of drive the piston carefully down just a little bit. Yeah, it's a little too much, but
I can still get a gap
without it hitting the other ring. And remember, the other ring is already at the bottom there. That was too much. Let me try it again. So that's a nice 21 thousandths right there. That's what I'm looking for. And that's it. That's one ring. You need to do that for all 8 top rings and then all 8 second rings. Now, what I've got here, as I said, I just did a second ring, but you can see it's up here on the top. And actually, I got this from somebody on the internet, and I thought it was a great idea. Just leave the rings in there. Some guys organize them on a pegboard and or boxes and or lay them out. Just leave them in the cylinders. They're gapped. They're not going anywhere. They're the correct size. It's not going to hurt them. And what I've got here now is I did the top rings, and they're at the bottom. And the second rings now are at the top. When I go to put these on the pistons now, I take the top ring that's on here, which is actually the second ring, put that on the piston, which is what goes on after the oil ring. And then put the top ring, which is the bottom one. That's just my technique, but if, you know, as long as you're organized, no big deal. But I just leave them in the cylinders, and now I know which ring is gapped for which piston. I grabbed, for instance, right here, I grabbed the number, that's the number 1357, I grabbed the number 7. Piston that's right here. I now know that that's the second ring, and then below it is the first ring for that piston. So that's it. We're ready to go on those pistons tomorrow. I'll put them in, I'll soak them in oil, and I'll be ready for the next step in the build process.